Okay, let's take a look at what I feel is one of the best ways to start a simple Node.js application, which is using npm as an initializer to that application. Let me explain what that means. So what I have done is I have here my desktop, and I've created this folder called WS for WebSockets. And what I would like to do here is I would like to create a bunch of small projects that are the WebSocket server, WebSocket client, processing, JavaScript, Grasshopper, all this stuff. We're just going to throw it in here, okay? And you can see that this WebSocket folder is living right now on my user folder and on my desktop. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open a command prompt. So I'm going to go to my Windows, icon, and then you can start typing the program that you want to search on your machine. So typically, I could type cmd to get a command prompt, but in this case, I like on Windows, I like much, much better Windows PowerShell. So this is what I'm going to do, and it's just open on my other screen. So I'm going to dock it here on the right end of my screen. PowerShell is like cmd, is like a command prompt, but it's a more evolved version of it. So it has way more features that are closer to Linux systems than they are to old MS-DOS. So maybe I should record a video about this at some point. But anyway, so you can see that right now I am on users JLX. So I can type dir to see everything that is on my folder, or I can type ls, which is the Unix way of doing this, which you can only do on PowerShell. You could not do that on cmd. You can see that I have my desktop folder, so I'm going to type cd desktop. You can see that I could type de and autocomplete with the tab to find the closest match to that. And I can also type cdws. So let me go back one. So I'm going to type ls to see everything that is on my desktop. You can see I have a lot of stuff. So I'm just going to type cdws, which is the folder that I have here. And you can see that as I type ls, there is nothing on my folder, which is empty. So what I can do is I'm going to create a new folder, which is going to be the WebSocket server that I'm creating for this example. So for example, I'm going to type here md, and I'm going to type the name of the folder that I want to create, which is going to be server echo. I'm going to create an echo server, all right? And then I'm going to type cd, and I'm going to get into that server, into that folder by typing the first few letters and then pressing tab to autocomplete for the rest. And now you can see that I am inside of server echo. You can see that also this just got created. I can see it on my Windows part. And I am ready to use this folder to initialize a Node application. The way I'm going to do this is by using what's called npm. npm is the package manager that comes with Node.js. You can think of it as the pip. If you're familiar with Python, it's basically the pip of Node.js. It's the application that we use to manage and to install packages. All right. If you're interested in what that is, you can go to npm and there's a lot of documentation and you can search here for packages. For example, I'm going to type WS, which is one of the most popular packages for doing WebSockets, which we're going to be using a lot in this tutorial. Okay. And what's interesting is that npm, for example, if I do npm slash v, I can see which version of npm I have installed, which you already have on your system, because if you follow my previous video where we install Node.js, npm comes with any installation of Node.js and it's already part of your system. So you don't need to take special care to install that on your end. Now, npm is really good at initializing projects, applications, because what it does is it creates a few files that are very necessary to maintain any Node application and all the dependencies that that application needs in order to execute. The way we do that is by, I'm going to clean this screen by doing CLS, and then I'm going to initialize a new application by typing npm init. As I do that, okay, this utility is going to walk me through a bunch of things that I need to specify. What are the properties and what are the parameters and the dependencies of my application? So the package name is going to be server echo, whatever, version 1.0, the description, some nice text here, whatever. The entry point is some JavaScript file, which I don't have on my system yet. I know that the file is going to be called server.js, so why not just write it right now? The entry point, the main file in my application, is going to be called server.js. Test command, we don't need to care about that. There's no Git repository yet for this. Keywords, author, license, whatever, blah, blah, blah. And if this is okay, we hit yes, and then you can see that NPM has created this new file on my application called package.json. And if I double click on that, it will be open. Let me actually do this the right way. So I'm going to open on my system the code editor that I typically use, which is Visual Studio Code, specifically for JavaScript files. So I'm going to put it in here, and then I'm going to drop this here. You can see that what NPM created is this one file called package.json, which incorporates all the information that my application needs in order to start, to install dependencies, etc., etc. This may not be very obvious right now, but we will see the utility of how this is useful very, very soon. Because, for example, if I want to install a package for my application to use, I will need to use it to install it through the Packet Manager. So, for example, as I said, we are going to be doing a lot of WebSocket examples in the videos that are coming up on this playlist. So I'm going to be using a lot of this one package, which you can see is extremely popular, which is a WebSocket library for Node.js. It's called just WS. So if I want to install that library on my application, the only thing I need to do is I need to type npm I, which stands for install, and then the name of the package. As I do that, see what it's called. I would like you to notice what is going to happen on my package JSON file. If I do here and I type npm install and then the name of the package that I want to install, WS, then npm takes care of going online, finding somewhere, whatever, and installing that on my system. You can see that npm has changed the JSON file and has added this part here. Now my project has a dependency, which is the WebSocket module, and it specifies which version I'm using here. You may also notice that if you go to the folder with your project, you will also notice that now I have this new folder called Node Modules, which includes WS, which includes all the files that are necessary for that module to execute. So now, any application that I might create here with Node.js will have access to the functionality that is coming with the package. And what's very interesting as well is that now anytime I take this whole code, including package.js, package.json, and I put it somewhere on the cloud or anywhere where a Node.js can be hosted, then that hosting will know that in order for my Node.js code to run, it will need to install these dependencies that are mandatory for my project. So this is a really good way. I will not need to upload all the modules myself. The only thing that I will need to upload to my cloud hosting, which will be the package.json file. Also, very typically, let's say I were to delete all these modules, okay? My dependencies are still here. But it so happens that when people share Node.js projects between them, very typically you don't bundle all the Node modules themselves, because it takes a lot of space, there's like thousands of files, it's just not nice. So what people do is they just share the core code and they share the package.json file. And then when you take that on your machine, what you do is you use this file to install all the dependencies that your module, that your application needs. So for example, the way to do that is, imagine somebody just gave me this code and I have no idea of what do I need to install. If there were like 17 different dependencies, I'm not going to go into the file and start typing them one by one. What I do is I simply type npm install, and then npm will try to find the package.json file, take a look at all the dependencies, and install them all one by one. So you can see that by installing npm I without specifying the package, npm has figured out all the dependencies and have installed them on my system. So now I'm ready to run whatever code I just have downloaded, which I don't have anything right now, but I will do in a second. Okay. So, all right. So we have all we need to actually start writing real code. So how about we do that? Let's move on to the next video where we're going to write a very simple WebSocket server. We're going to execute it, we're going to run it, and then we're going to test it and see if it works. Okay, let's take a look at that.